Praise the Lord. I am Pastor J.B. Norman Jr., and this is my lovely wife, First Lady Dolores G. Norman, and we are from the Rivers of Living Water Faith Church, inviting you to one of our powerful packed services, Wednesdays at 7 p.m. and Sunday morning at 11 a.m., 309 J.B. Norman Jr. Drive. Always remember, we love you, and God loves you too. Praise the Lord. Now, I'm J.B. Norman Jr. We want you to stay tuned. Do not turn your dial.
Every day and in every way, my life is getting better and better. I'll speak to my morning. The reason I said that is because you have to start off your day with a praise. You have to start off your day with a positive note. You have to start your day off with a scripture. Something that's going to boost your day. Something that's going to give you a positive outlook on your day. Not my day, not your sister's day, not your son's day. Your day. Because when you are blessed, when you have a positive attitude, when you have the right outlook, do you not know that that overflows to other people? Have you ever did this? Have you ever smiled at somebody, said nothing to them, and they smiled back at you? That's because you're sowing seed. It's in you. Give it back. Amen?
Father God, we just give you all the honor. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise, Father God. Father God, we thank you for each and every person that took out of their schedule today to be here on tonight, Lord God, to receive from you, Lord God. We thank you that every word that is spoken, Lord God, every song that is sung, every musical note that is played, Father God, ministers to your people, Lord God. Father God, we thank you for anointing the speakers on tonight, Lord God. But Father God, let every word be coming from on high, Lord God. Let it pierce our spirits, Father God. Father God, we thank you for every opportunity that you give us to wake up and have breath in our bodies, Father God. Father God, we just give you all the honor, and we give you all the glory, and we give you all the praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
All ye hands, serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. Is it he that have made us and not we ourselves?
Welcome, welcome, and welcome to Rivers of Living Water Faith Church Thanksgiving service. We want you all to enjoy. We want you to get your praise on. We want you to get your shout on. And we most of all want you to come and know all is well and smile and know that we love you and God loves you too. Once again, welcome.
That God, my God, God is good.
Yes, he is.
God, my God, God is good. Oh, that he brought me out of darkness. God is good. Oh, that he saved my soul. God is good. Said he saved my soul. God is good.
Said
he guides my every footstep. God is good. I know that he guides my every footstep. Then he saved my soul. And then he brought me out of darkness. God is good.
You know, when I look back over my life and I think back where God has brought me from, I can't help but to say hallelujah. Amen. Even through heartaches, pain, and uncomfortable situation, I still learned to praise his name and say hallelujah. Amen. You know, back in 2015, both of my parents transitioned to be with the Lord 3.5 months apart from each other. And as a matter of fact, on the 26th of this month,
It will be 2 months exact for my mother. But still through that, I give him the glory, the honor, and the praise. That's a pain that I wouldn't wish for anyone to have, but I still give him the glory. You know, sometimes I even find myself crying and thanking God for the grace that he has given me and my brothers to be able to be an overseer over my brother Philandus, who is 100% disabled veteran. You know, a lot of people don't have people to care about them, but that's a grace, and it's not easy, but I thank God through that anyway. You know, God has done so much for me that it's not enough time to even tell half of what he has done. But I do want to encourage you on tonight and tell you, throw a couple of nuggets out there why we should always be thankful, why we should always give him the praise. Number one, we should thank him for allowing us to answer the call. I'm not talking about the call to salvation. I'm talking about the call, he said, the day you hear his voice. He said, the day you hear his voice, harden not your heart. The call to salvation. The call, everyone will have the opportunity to be saved, but everyone will have the grace to get saved. Over in John 10:28, Jesus said, he has given us eternal life and we shall never perish. He said, we will never perish. He will never be plucked out of his hand. We won't even be plucked out of the Father's hand. Now that's something to give him praise for. Even Paul said over in Romans 8:38 in the Amplified Bible, he said, for I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor the presence, nor the threatened things, or things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor even created things can separate us from the love of God. And last but not least, the psalmist said, let's enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his holy name. You know, the psalmist is conveying to me that you should always come before the Lord with a thankful and grateful heart. When you come before the Lord with a thankful and grateful heart and giving him the praise, you'll begin to enter into his presence. And when you enter into his presence, you'll find yourself having a peace that bypasses all understanding. You'll find yourself not having the concerns of this world. And then you'll also find yourself getting so wrapped up into his presence that you'll hear his voice, that he'll say, hey, don't go that way today. Go this way because it's an accident that way. You'll hear him say that, hey, apply for this job. Even though you don't qualify for it, I'm going to give it to you anyway. He'll hear him say, hey, don't go to the grocery store at this time, but go at this time, and behind you somebody will pay for your groceries. That's something to praise God for. And then you'll find yourself walking in the authority and the provision that he has already laid before you, because he said he knew you before he formed you in your mother's belly. And then he will always know your beginning, your middle, and the end. Now that's something to give God praise for. So everybody stand on your feet tonight and give him the praise, the glory, and the honor. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
The center of my joy. All that's good and perfect comes from you. You're the very heart of my contentment, hope for all center of my joy. When I've lost my direction, you're the compass for my way. You're the fire and light when nights are long and cold. Shatters all my tears when I'm all alone. Your hand is there to hold. Oh, you are the center of my joy. Ain't nobody like you. Yes, I know it comes from you, nobody like you. Lord, you hold for all everything I do. Oh, Jesus, you are. You're the center of my joy. Why I find pleasure in the simple things in life. You're my music that never stops. Oh, you're my meadows and my streams. Oh, voices of the children, my family in my home. You're the source and finish of my highest praise. Oh, Jesus, I love calling your name, Jesus. Something happens when I call the name, Jesus. Everything that I need, he supplies. He gives it unto me. He won't turn his back on me. You're the center of my joy, Jesus. Hey, you are. Oh, you're the center of every bit of my joy.
I just want to exhort you a little bit tonight, just about Thanksgiving, about the power of thanksgiving and praise, about the power of giving thanks to God. Okay, we already know, Philippians 4:6 talks about be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. That means in every situation and in every circumstance, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, continue to make your specific requests known unto God. Specific requests. You could be very specific with God, and when you're giving praise to God. And now, I looked at that word thanksgiving, and I found out that the word thanksgiving, the Greek definition of the word thanksgiving means good grace. It means good grace. That's the Greek definition of the word thanksgiving. So now 1 Thessalonians 5:18 tells you that in everything, give thanks. That is again talking about everything. In everything, give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. The will of God, you're giving thanks, but this is the will of God. And God's will is his word. 1 John 5:14 said, this is the confidence that we have to him. If you ask anything according to his will, God heareth us. And if we know if God hears us, then we know we have the petition and the desire of him. And that word petition means the answers. All right, glory to God. So when you give thanks to God, this is one thing about what's so important about the prayer. Because see, prayer of thanksgiving and praise, that's a prayer. That's another prayer. We got the prayer of faith, the prayer of intercession, the prayer of agreement, the prayer of dedication and worship. We have those type prayer. But this is a prayer too, a prayer of thanksgiving and praise. They call thanksgiving and praise because, see, when you give thanks to God, God will bestow upon you his ability and anointing of special favor at a higher level. So that is the manifestation of God's power. That's the manifestation of his power. So like I said, so when you give thanks to God in everything, because you have the power in Jesus Christ to overcome whatever is troubling you or whatever you're going through as you give the praise to God. Because you give the praise to God, because see, 1 John 5:4 say, whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. So you have to use your faith in order to be to give praise and worship and give thanksgiving to God. So when God does something special, when God does something special for you, with this anointing, his ability of his special favor on you, you must match it with an earnest outpouring of thanks. What are you thanking it for? Thanks God for your healing. You know, you might have a sickness in your body. If you're going through the sickness in your body, you don't thank it God because you're going through the sickness. You're thanking God that for your healing because, you know, because by stripes you are already healed. You're thanking God. You need to thank God for your salvation. That God saved you, pulled you out of your mess when you was in your mess, when you was in the world. You need to thank God for that. You can thank God for filling you with his precious Holy Spirit, with the evidence of speaking with other tongues. You need to thank him for that. You need to thank God for your family. Your family is all, as your family is covered by the blood of Jesus, because you got your, because I know I put Psalms 91 over my family. I put Psalms 91 over on them, because you need to thank God and praise God. I pray over my little baby daughter when I take her to school every morning. I lay hands on her and pray for her, because and I thank God for that, for what she do while she in school. I thank God for my wife. I thank God for my daughter, for all my daughters. In fact, all my daughters are all here tonight, and I thank God for that. And but think about it. But God showed me this about dealing with my mother. I really thank God for my mother, because my mother had a doctor appointment about a few months ago, and she told me that what the doctor said to her and told her that he said to her, "Well, Miss Jackson, you need to tell me, what are you doing? Because he said everything look good on you. I don't see anything. Everything look good on you." And my mother is in her early 80s. But I just thank God. That's the something to give God praise for. So I just want to leave you here tonight to let you know that when you're giving thanks to God, no, you give thanks to God, because see, that is just a special favor. As you give praise to God, the manifestation of God's power will come upon you with special favor at a higher level by you giving that praise and thanksgiving given unto God. Glory to God.
Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord. I hope that didn't go with my 3 minutes, but I had to do it. God, I thank you. I had to go old school tonight, because it's old school that brought me through. Hallelujah. When you've been through some things in life, when you've been through abuse, when you've been through guns held to your head, when you've been through times when you had to lay your hands on your cabinets and pray for some food in your house for you and your kids, when God sends somebody to you to bring you some food to your door, and she's here tonight, and I thank God for her. Thank you, God. I give honor and glory to my pastor and his wife on tonight, because they helped this little Baptist girl come up to a higher level. God had a purpose and a plan for my life, and they helped me to get where he wanted me to be. No matter what the enemy did, God is always there. No matter what he does to you, just hold on to God's unchanging hand. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. One thing that I had been believing God for a long, 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 long time was a home. My children were little, and I was out looking for a home. God, this is what I want, this is what I want, I want this, 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 this. I said, "Lord, I thank you." My children grown and gone, but my daddy, my faithful God, manifested it this year. Hallelujah. And he is so on time. He is so on time. He wasn't late. The blessing wasn't held up. He has a plan. He has a designated time for everything. My mother is 89 years old. And who's staying with me? It's a perfect home for us. And I thank God for that. And it's been such a blessing, a testimony, because my children are now saying, "Mama, God did it. All these many years, God did it." When God said, if it takes 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, even 30 years, if I said it, it shall come to pass. Hallelujah. 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 And he also said, when I take you to that place of blessing, don't forget me. And that's what I'm going to say to you tonight. Don't forget him. Hallelujah. Glory. And don't compare yourself with anyone else. If your blessing comes in 5 years and you've been saved 40 and yours still hasn't come to pass, believe God. Exercise your faith. Hold on with all that you have, because God is faithful. If he did it for me, he'll do it for you and you and you. Thank you, God. On yesterday, when we were practicing for the hat dance, the anointing of God came in so strong. I just wept and cried. I boohooed. I had to just say I'm sorry, but I could not hold it. So I wanted to reiterate those words to you on tonight. If you would just stand to your feet and repeat after me. And the song, it says, he brought me out of darkness. He brought me out of darkness. He saved my soul.
He saved my soul.
He guides my every footstep.
He guides my every footstep.
He put shoes on my feet.
He put shoes on my feet.
He put food on my table.
He put food on my table.
He made a way out of no way.
He made a way out of no way.
With no money in my pocket.
No money in my pocket.
He heals every sickness.
He heals every sickness.
So I say to you tonight,
and Lord,
be satisfied with Jesus. Be thankful to God for each and everything. Love on him. Be grateful. Have an humble spirit at all times. And do what he has for you to do. Be focused. Do what he has for you to do. In Jesus' name.
Somebody ought to say amen today.
Amen.
Thank God for my friends up here.
Amen.
Lord, we've been friends for a long time.
Amen.
My God, my God, my God. And as Pastor Norman said, this is the perfect time.
Amen.
Because it's harvest time.
Amen.
Can you look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, it's time for the harvest. Oh, my Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And one of my friends, glory to God, was trying to bring her to the Lord. Well, she said, I'm going to church with you tomorrow. But didn't know, she had not planned to go to church with me. So God said, go to her house. That was on a Saturday night. God said, go there. So went there. Went to a house. Hey, girl. I said, yeah, girl, you still going to church with me tomorrow? And she said, Annie, what's wrong with my church? I mean, I go to church. Let me tell you something. If you want a peach, you go to the peach tree.
Yeah.
Can you say amen? If you want an apple, you go to the apple tree. And if you want the Holy Ghost, you got to go where the believers are. Come on, somebody. See, when God wanted to work a miracle, Jesus Christ, glory to God, many said, the girl is not dead. Hallelujah. And they began to laugh him to scorn. The Lord said, she's not dead. She's only sleeping. And they laughed and they laughed and they laughed. But he told the believers, unbelievers, said, get out. Get out. And then he said, may arise. It's harvest time. Isn't this the time for harvest? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I began to see spider webs just covering her brain. And I said, let's pray. So we got down on our knees and began to pray, and I said, Lord, remove those spider webs. Remove every spider web that's covering our brain, trying to cloud the word of God out of it. And when we got up off our knees, tears were lapping her cheek, and said, you are going to pick me up tomorrow, aren't you? Come on, somebody. See, you cannot give up. Come on, somebody. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, it's harvest time. It's time to bring somebody to God. Come on, Jesus. Come on, Jesus. Come on, Jesus. Come on, Jesus. Hallelujah. And when you see somebody, and they were coming to church, and glory to God, you don't see them anymore, you need to get on that phone and say, hello. 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 Hallelujah. My God. This is a telephone call from heaven. The Lord is looking for you. Somebody ought to say amen. Can somebody say thank you? Hallelujah. 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 Then this lady, she said, I'll never get baptized another day in my life. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I've already been baptized, and I'm not going back down in any water again. Come on, somebody. But let me tell you, through the witnessing, telling God she needed to be filled with the Holy Ghost. One Saturday, glory to God, she started crying and couldn't stop crying. Had to stop what I was doing. Go to her house. Hallelujah. Go there. When we got there, she was still crying. She said, I was barbecuing, and I had to take the meat off the pit. Jesus. Yes. Yes. She said, I want to go to church tomorrow and get baptized. Hallelujah. Somebody ought to say amen. See, all you've got to do is step out in faith. When you step out, then that's when God will move. Hallelujah, because see, they are already chosen. Somebody ought to say amen. And her husband said, I'm a staunch Catholic, and I'll never be anything else but a Catholic. Come on, somebody. Come on, Jesus. Come on, Jesus. And we began to tell him, you're calling somebody father, and there's no father but the Father in heaven. Let me tell you, one day, God put a troubling on him. Yeah, I told you all I would never get baptized again, and I would be a Catholic. He said, but I'm ready for the Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody. Come on, Jesus. 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 Immediately, sometime you got to stop what you're doing. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You've got to tell others about what God has done for you. Look at your neighbor and say, I've got to tell it. I've got to tell it. He said, you see the harvest over there. He said, don't you see out there? He said, can't you see the harvest? It's ripe and is ready for picking. See, God has the people already ready. Ready to receive what you've got to tell them. And you've got to go immediately. God said he wants a soul-winning regime. Look at your neighbor and say, that's a takeover. A soul-winning regime. A takeover of winning souls. Amen. Amen. You know when the Lord knocked Saul off the horse on the road to Damascus.
Praise the Lord. I am Pastor J.B. Norman Jr. and this is my lovely wife, First Lady Lawrence G. Norman. And we are from the Rivers of Living Water Faith Church, inviting you to one of our powerful packed services, Wednesdays at 7 p.m. and Sunday morning at 11 a.m. 309 J.B. Norman Jr. Drive. Always remember, we love you and God loves you too.